birth name was Sharon Ann Swore. I was born in August of 1944 in Orange, California, Long Beach, California. I came to Nevada in November of 1965. I had been adopted to a military person and when I was 5 years old, my mother married another fellow, and he was my father as long as I can actually remember. His name was Billy Robert Whitlock. We traveled all over the country. We were in Nevada several times. The first time that I was ever in Nevada, I think I was about 6.5 years old, and we went to Death Valley, and we skirted Pahrump. We didn't come through here, but we did go through Beatty. So that was the first time that I'd ever been in Nevada. Most of my growing up time, I was either in Long Beach, California, San Diego, California, Alameda, California, Oakland. Then we went up to Bellingham, Bremerton, Washington, where the ships were all refitted. I was there in my second and third grade year. My first grade year, I was in Arizona. Goodyear, California. That was where all the old airplanes were stored from World War II. I used to play on those airplanes. It was a lot of fun. Loved it. They were very upset with me about that. Moved to Lemon Grove, California after that. Went back to Alameda, California, and then went to Japan. Came back from Japan, went back to Long Beach, California, and then moved to Washington State, where I graduated from high school. Went to Norfolk, Virginia. I guess at the end of seventh grade, we went to Japan and we spent some time there, and then went back to Long Beach. So anyway, I've been all over the country. My mom moved to Beatty, we followed, and I found a very, very nice guy, got married. We were in Beatty for probably 6-7 months, and he worked for the Nevada test site. We moved to Pahrump because it was closer. He only had about 45 miles to go instead of 75 or 80 miles. So it made it much easier for him. He worked 3.5 days a week. He was a deputy sheriff at the test site. And by the end of 1969, we had 2 children. We divorced in 1972, I believe. Late 71, early 72, and I stayed in Pahrump, and he moved to Las Vegas. About that same time, we decided that we really needed an ambulance crew here, because the soberest drunk was the one that took you into the hospital, and the ambulance was actually parked next to the Cotton Picket Saloon. So there were 6 people, I was one of them, that got together, and we went through the old PRIN program. And that was an 80-hour course. Then the emergency medical technician course came in right after that, and we all went through that. So we ran the ambulance crew for probably 5-6 years. In 1975, in June, the then sheriff, Jay Howard, put together a reserve program Well, first he put together search and rescue, and we all joined search and rescue. That was in June. And in October of that year, we split apart because some people didn't want to carry a gun or do anything like that. So they decided that they wanted to stay on the search and rescue side, and we decided that we would rather be on the law enforcement side. So on October 15th, 1975, we put together the reserve program. I stayed in that reserve program until 2003. In December of 1975, I went to work for the Nevada Test Site. Up to that point, from the time that I got a divorce on, I ran an insurance agency. I got my insurance license. And so I worked in Las Vegas for a little while, and then I had a little insurance agency out here in Toronto. So in 1975, in December, I decided that I really needed benefits for my children, and I was offered a job at Wackenut Services Incorporated, which is the protective force for the Nevada Test Site. And so I joined, and I was there for 25 years.